Hi guys, and welcome to another video from Newgate Nurseries. I know this is a terrible time for everybody. We've had to shut the nursery now, and I know everybody's in lockdown. So we're going to think of something. Gardening is one of the only things we can do at the moment to cheer us up. So we're going to look at veg, in particular potatoes. We're going to tell you about the variety of stuff that we have growing at the nursery. It'll all be available on a web shop soon. Otherwise, just call the nursery and we'll deliver it for free. But it's more about showing you a few things that you could do at home. One of the easiest veg to grow are potatoes. So I'll just give you a few pointers. We'll talk about, first of all, the different groups of potatoes. So you've got first earlies, second earlies, and main crop. Your first earlies need to go in now. If your first earlies go in now, they'll be ready in about 10 weeks. Your second earlies, they're going to be about 15 weeks. And your main crop's usually about 20 to 22 weeks from putting them in to eating them. So, to start with your main crop, we've got some old favourites. We've got King Edward, Desiree, and we've got Morris Piper. I think everybody knows that one. Your second earlies, so they're the mid-range. Then you've got Charlotte, Kestrel, Morris Pier, a particularly good variety. You've got Foremost, which is a first early now, so these are the ones that are going to come ready the first. Red Duke of York, Aran Pilot, which is probably the most versatile potato, and Sharp's Express. So, how do you do it? Well, it's not hard. So first of all, when you get your seed potatoes, these are particularly good sized seed potatoes, what you're looking for are your chits. Now these haven't chitted yet, they've just come in from Scotland, but as you can see, they're about to start. So if you were to buy these today, you would get them out of the package, and you would lie them all with the chits facing up on a seed tray or in an egg carton, and just put them somewhere warm. If you want to force it and you want them to be ready to plant quicker than maybe 1 or 2 weeks, which is what it normally takes, put them somewhere warm and dark, but only for a few days, because that'll just force these chits to start looking for light and growing. And as soon as those chits get to about this big, about a centimetre, you're good to go. Okay, what we're looking for in a potato is two good chits. If you can see this one here, you've got about five or six all around, sprouting from all over the tuber. What you're looking for, sit them in a tray, look for these two prominent chits, rub any of the others off. Let these two get to about this size. So when you've chitted your potatoes, ideal place, you can put them in the garage, probably take about 10 days, 2 weeks. If you want to do it a bit quicker, airing cupboard, under the stairs, anything like that. All right, they'll soon shoot. So in an average container, you're looking for about five potatoes to get you a decent crop. All right, now these are all different sizes, it doesn't matter. Once they've chitted, okay, so let's look into the future, and let's say they've chitted, we're looking for a container to grow them in. So rigid plastic pot, whatever you've got lying around, no problem, that's easy. Okay, you can buy a specific potato bag, and a lot of these come with flaps that you can open up and then harvest the potatoes from underneath. Or if you don't want to spend any money, which at the moment we can fully understand, bag for life. Everyone's got them, you always get them when you go to the supermarket because you've forgotten your bag. This one just made some holes in the bottom. You can do that with a barrow or a knife, anything like that, okay? And then you can use that. Now, they're just about big enough, these bags for life. If you can get a bigger one, even better. The deeper, the better with potatoes. All right, so what we're gonna do, we're gonna use a good quality compost. You can use a mixture of topsoil and organic soil conditioner. That's a really good mix. Or if it's just ease you want, Jack's Magic's probably the best one, because that's got extra seaweed in it, it's got good drainage, it's got sand in it, so these potatoes aren't gonna swim in water if it lashes it down for the next 3 weeks. All right, if you can mix a bit of grit in with the compost when you're doing it, even better. Okay, and just keep piling it up. You want about 6 inches is probably the minimum, really, but if you're using a bag for life and it's not that big, you could probably get away with about 4 inches. So that's about 10 centimetres. Okay, so once you've got your compost in, you've firmed it down, you've got to imagine these have now got a 1 centimetre chit. We're just going to sit them in with a bit of space between the tubers. We'll get another one out. So we've got 5 potatoes in a bag of this size. That's more than enough. Now, if you wanted to increase your yield, all right, then using something called superphosphate is the way forward. So superphosphate's aimed at roots and at root vegetables. You'd sprinkle this underneath the tubers, and as soon as they start putting roots down and growing, they would suck this up and you get a better yield. All right, this costs about £3.99. So, once your tubers are in, you've got to then cover them up. So in a bag, you're going to cover these up by about 2 or 3 inches of soil. If you're planting these in the ground or on your allotment, it's a different ball game. What you need to create are ridges in the soil. So I'll just show you, finish this one off. But very simple. So they're fully covered. Once that's done, you've firmed it down, give them a water. Then, in a few days' time, you're going to start seeing the little chits popping above the soil. At that point, you need to then mound more over the top, and it's just a continual game of mounding over your potatoes until you get to the top of the container. At that point, the growth will appear, and then they'll just keep growing. Then it gets to sort of June, July. Once the white flowers start appearing, then you're good to start harvesting. All right, don't let them dry out. Don't overwater. If you get a wet summer, just put them somewhere a little bit sheltered if you can, because that's when blight happens. But otherwise, that's it for potatoes. It's very easy. It's just bob them in and then harvest them and enjoy them. If growing them in the ground, we need to create ridges. And this is where it gets a little bit more technical. But basically, your ridges need to be about 2 foot apart. And you need to bury your potatoes a depth of 6 inches. And you need to put them about 10 inches apart in the rows. And again, it's the same idea that you're going to be mounding all the time as they start to grow. Okay, so first earlies, that'll give you a quick crop. That's like 12 weeks. And then you've got your second earlies, which are going to be about 15 weeks. And then you've got your main crop, which is about 20 weeks. So all that you can plant, so you've got a succession of potatoes right through to sort of October. All right, so it's a great way of being self-sufficient. As we know how the shops are at the moment, so it's ideal just to plan ahead, and you can do this without a garden. You can do it anywhere you want. So that's potatoes. The sea potatoes that we sell here, the Scottish sea potatoes, the two kilos, and they're only £3.99 or 3 bags for a tenner. And like I say, if you're anywhere in the local area, these can be just dropped off for free for you. All right, same with the compost. Now then, other veg that we do. So if you're looking to start growing things, again, you can grow veg in all sorts of containers or in your allotment or in the ground. I'll just show you what we've got on the go at the moment. So in the veg, guys, we've got runner beans, French beans, we've got broad beans, we've got peas, that's a good one for the kids. We've got Brussels sprouts, cabbage, 3 or 4 types of lettuce. We've got celery. These are only young, but they're coming through fast. We've got cauliflower, leeks, and another good one for the kids is sweet corn. All right, so all these are available. There's 12 plants in a tray. It's £2.99 for a tray, or 4 trays for a tenner. And it doesn't matter if you ring up and you just want one tray of veg, it doesn't matter, we'll deliver it. No charge. In order to make your veg better, especially leafy veg, these are two things that you can use, okay? Liquid seaweed. If you can't bother making it yourself, then you can buy it in liquid form, okay? That's brilliant. It's just a good all-round feed for strengthening, and it's purely organic, so that's a good one if you want organic gardening. If you want something that's going to boost growth a little quicker, then Kenpak number 2. That's fantastic for all your veg, especially lettuce, cabbage, things that you want to get into a nice firm heart. All right, so that's your veg. Just to give you an idea of what we grow. Right, we'll go and do the tomatoes. But they're on heat, so I'll have to go down to the bottom ground. Okay guys, so now we're in a warm greenhouse. This has got underfloor heating, and this is where we grow all our tomatoes, melon plants, cucumbers. So it's really important. We've got a lot of people ringing up wanting tomatoes, and yeah, that's fine. But just be aware that you need that warmth. If you don't have the warmth, it's going to like minus one, I think, in the next few days, then just wait a week or two, just until we get out of the woods of the bad frosts. So these plants aren't big. I pricked these out probably about 2 weeks ago. They're making nice, good, strong growth now. The roots are just coming through. I don't know if you can see that, but your roots are just coming through. These are in a cardboard pot, 10 centimetre. So these don't need to come out of the pot. These will go straight into the grow bags or the pots that you're going to put them in. But just be aware that these nice, tender roots don't like to be disturbed too much, so don't try and take them out of this pot. Okay, so these are only young, so they need to be kept warm. So if you've nowhere to keep them warm, maybe think April, mid-April, that's when these can start to go in. So we've got a lot of varieties here. We grow, for cherry tomatoes, we grow Gardener's Delight. So Gardener's Delight is one of the most old-fashioned and tried and tested tomatoes. It's a little sweet cherry and it can be grown outside, okay? We also, in the small tomatoes, have one called Tumbler. And that's a great one for putting in a hanging basket. One in a 10-inch basket, or two in a 14-inch, and that'll give you loads of tomatoes cropping outside during the summer. Other varieties that we have are mid-range. So we've got Shirley, which is a good old-fashioned favourite. We've got Alicante. We've got Moneymaker, probably the most popular one. And then Black Russian, which has a nice sort of dark purple tint to the fruit. Also, we've got in the larger tomatoes, we also have a Sun Gold, which is a nice yellow tomato, something of a novelty. And then finally, we've got Marmoran, which is the big beefsteak tomato. So all these are available in these 10 centimetre cardboard pots. They're £1.50 each, four for a fiver, all right? Again, if you only want four tomatoes, doesn't matter, we'll drop them off, all right? Now, ideally, I would grow these in a Westland tomato grow bag, simply because it's got more depth than the other grow bags. The Newsatella cheaper yellow one at £2.99. The Westland ones are 2 for £10, okay? Or grow them in multi-purpose and John Innes, because that's really good open compost, but it does retain its moisture, so they're not going to dry out. And grow them in a 15-litre plastic pot. Okay, that gives them a bit more depth. You do need a greenhouse for all those varieties, apart from Tumbler and Gardener's Delight. Okay. Also, cucumbers. Now, cucumbers are very popular. These are just germinated. They're about a week old. All right, in another week, they'll be ready to go. This variety is an all-female variety. It's a slightly dwarf cucumber. It doesn't need any pollination or any messing about. And your cucumber will end up being about this big. All right. We also do we do peppers, melon plants, aubergines, so the full range really. So remember, the Westland tomato plant is that deeper one, gives the better results, or grow them in pots. And then finally, feeding them. I'll take you to the feeds now and we'll have a look at which feeds best for the tomatoes, okay? Okay guys, right, so growing tomatoes or any fruiting plant, we need to work hard on the feed, because that's the main thing, okay? So the difference between feeding and not feeding, if you don't feed, yeah, you'll still get fruit, but if you do feed and you feed with the right things, you're going to get twice the amount of fruit, okay? So obviously everybody goes for tomato feed, because it is what it says in a bottle, it's for feeding tomatoes, and you also use it for hanging baskets and flowers. It's cheap, it's £2.99. four bottles for a tenner. But what we're going to do is have a look and compare it to something else called Kempak number 4. This is Kempak number 4, high potash feed. Okay, now this is £6.99, that's £2.99. So what's the difference? Well, whenever you're looking at a fertilizer, I don't know if you can zoom in on that, we've got three numbers. Okay, the first number is nitrogen, so that's for growing, green growth. The second number is for roots. Okay, so that's balanced, growing and roots. The last number is for flowering, fruiting and for yield. Okay, so on this more premium fertilizer, which works well for hanging baskets and for fruit and for tomatoes, your ratio is 15 15 30. So 15 for growing, 15 for roots, 30 for fruiting and flowering. So balanced in the first two, which is a key, because your growth and your roots working hand in hand, and double for fruiting and flowering. So that's ideal. as a summer feed for all your plants. Looking at the tomato feed, the cheaper alternative, you've got a ratio, if you can see that, of 4-2-6. So 4 for growing, 2 for roots, 6 for fruiting. Again, it's a weaker feed, it'll still work, but it won't work as well as the Kempite number 4. So application is usually once a week, 2 scoops in a watering can for the Kempak, and for the tomato feed it's usually a capful in a watering can. Okay, so that's what we do. You can use these on all your flowers as well, that's the main thing. So you're buying one feed for the year rather than them to buy about 5 different feeds. As you can see on the shelves here, we've got feeds for absolutely everything, for every individual plant, and a lot of different plants do need different nutrient ratios. But if you're just looking at flowering and fruiting for your bedding plants and your tomatoes, then Kempite number 4 is the one. Okay?
Done. Dostras.
At this time of crisis, then the country's all pulling together, we really need to thank our key workers and our NHS staff, because without them, we'd be in trouble. So what we're doing at Newgate to thank them is 4 of these planters every week are going to be given away to some of our local key workers. We need you guys to either comment on this video, this YouTube video, or go on our Facebook site and basically give us the names of the people that you think deserve these. We'll then contact you, get their address, and we'll drop them off at their door. All right, this is a little thank you from Newgate to the workers. Thank you.